Hi everyone. It's nice to be here once again. It's been a week of a lot of news around board institutions, you know, things like that. I think First Bank had a little, I don't want to call it a brouhaha, but some things went on between the First Bank and the Central Bank. And of course, we expect that a new board will be instituted. But be that as it may, several companies are still doing all that they can. People are pushing out best talents. People are ensuring that they have all that it takes to move the company from one point to another. Companies are facing different challenges, disruptions everywhere, innovations everywhere. Like, it's a good time. It's actually a good time to be within a board system or a company system to drive growth, to drive change, to drive profits. This is the best time. There's no other time. The pandemic has shown or has brought forth the weaknesses in the systems of a lot of companies, basically. So today, I just want to shed a little light on what I might title the recruitment process for independent directors or advisory board members. What really goes on? How do those people emerge? You know, we are so closely knit in society. The social media has made a lot of things so easy. But the first consideration in terms of recruiting for advisory board positions is, number one, the chairman's recommendations. The chairman of the board is a very influential member of the company, and in some cases, in some privately owned companies, there's a possibility that the CEO, sometimes where, you know, the corporate governance rules are quite loosely interpreted, the CEO can be, he might not be the MD, he might be the CEO, and he can also be the chairman of the board of directors. He sits over the affairs of the independent directors or the advisory board, as the case may be. So the chairman's recommendations is very, very key. When you're thinking about the individuals that you want to bring on board an advisory board system, I'm sure that consideration should definitely be given to who the chairman thinks that the cap fits. I don't know if that makes sense. So we need to put into consideration what the chairman is thinking about. Another thing that happens basically has to do with LinkedIn, for example. LinkedIn is another powerful tool. When you use LinkedIn, you have to use LinkedIn from a position of insight into who your executive director, who your EDs are, who your CEO is, who your COO is. You are looking at the skill sets that already exist within the company. So when you are going to LinkedIn, your job is not to go and duplicate what is already existing within the company. What's your job simply? Your job is simply to ensure that those skills that are definitely relevant and important that the company actually needs, your job is to go to LinkedIn and look for people that have those skills that do not already exist in the company. I also expect that to be the pre-consideration of the chairman when he's making his recommendation based on the first point that we actually made. But LinkedIn gives you a wide array of individuals that you can actually choose from, and you can narrow down based on certain criteria that the company intends to use to be able to get. If, for example, you are looking for people that are less than 30, between 25 and 30, you can easily search that out. If you're looking for people between 40 and 50, depending on the experience, you're looking at experience, you need experienced hands. Or if you're looking at young, innovative, and dynamic individuals, you know, you're thinking of the Gen Z and all that, you want to get them on board. You know, those kind of guys, they come in with crazy ideas. If you're looking for people that want to play it safe, that have the experience, they want to drive growth in a systemic format, you know, things like that, you can actually work that entire thing out. So the next thing I'm actually trying to say basically is that when you're thinking of some of all these things beyond LinkedIn, another thing that can actually happen is you can engage the services of recruitment agencies. Yeah, you can actually engage recruitment agencies, give them a set of criteria that you're actually thinking about, and also make them understand why they need to get certain kinds of persons that you need within that organization So for that, of course, you would need to pay a recruitment agency, get some consultants, some HR consultants involved, and ask them to help you get the best kinds of people. One other thing, that's for number four now. The fourth thing, I think, basically is, and it happens a lot. You're on social media, for example, and you see a post about maybe a business event taking place. It can be a HR conference, it can be a strategic blah, 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 or whatever, this and that. You know, you can have some of those kinds of people who have been called upon to grace the occasion, maybe as speakers, as moderators, as judges, as whatever capacity, basically. You can also tell yourself that, okay, I want to look at some of the lineup for this particular conference. You can pick your advisory board from there. You know, you have an opportunity to see that people have chosen the brightest minds within a sector or an industry to come and grace an occasion, to come and grace an event. And therefrom, you can now see that, oh, these people, they have, especially when they read out their profile, you begin to hear some of those things. Then you listen in. You know, this is like a pro tip for boards, basically, when you're thinking of consulting your board. You listen to their profile, in fact, it gives you a first-hand opportunity to be able to assess those individuals. So one of the things you can do, you can look out for such kind of events. I know Fela Drew Toya and some other, Jimmy Tewe, there are a whole lot of them. They run a lot of these events. They bring in the best minds, valuable individuals. They come to some of these conferences and they deliver hands-on 110% delivery. You know, those kind of people are people that you can actually assess, you know, through some of those, you know, events. Another thing I was saying in line with that, I once had the opportunity of running an interview with someone, and a board chair used that opportunity to assess one of the guests that we're actually speaking about. So that's just what I'm trying to say. It provides a platform for people to be able to say, okay, I'm looking at this person. I haven't met the person individually, but the person is speaking on a certain subject matter area for which the company might be able to draw, you know, some inflow out of that person to the benefit of the company. Why don't you just listen in? So that's one of the ways. Number four or five now is the company secretary's recommendation. You know, as much as the board is concerned, the company secretary is one individual who is very important within the workings of the board. He has actually, most of the times, he outlives independent directors on the board. He outlives them. Those ones, they are tenure based. They come for 2 years. Maybe you can keep them on board for another 2 years. But you find companies where company secretaries can be there for 6 years, 8 years, even 10 years, as the case may be. So the point is that the company secretary has seen the direction in which the company has been moving, and he can also make recommendations, maybe based on personal referrals as well. He can refer individuals that he feels will be able to do a great job with that company. It doesn't necessarily have to mean that those people might be personal friends of the company secretary. No, he might not have any religious inclination. He might just be looking at that issue holistically in a way that is hinged on the interest of the company being met. So I feel those are some of the tips, those are some of the pro tips that, you know, when you're thinking of recruiting for an independent board. And I'm saying all of this because I know that it applies even to big companies. It applies to big companies, publicly listed companies. These rules also apply. But I'm thinking of a scenario where businesses that are just taking off, startups, you know, founder enterprises, you know, things like that, family businesses. I'm just thinking that you don't really need to go out of this world to be able to get the how of getting the brightest team on board. You can just use these simple methods I've mentioned. If you're having that challenge, go on Instagram, check out some of all these things. Go to Trisha Bees, for example, check out her page. Events are always going on around that. There's this also, AGS Tribe. You can find good people, excellent people are listed on AGS Tribe. So I think that's run by Ife Jirosimieti. You can check her out on Instagram. So you can find excellent people listed on some of the events that are taking place by these very top tier individuals. And from the look of things, if you really zoom in, you don't really need so much. You don't need to run around all the information is there that you actually need to get the brightest minds involved. So we've talked about the chairman's recommendations. We've talked about using LinkedIn as a tool. We've talked about engaging recruitment agencies. We've talked about checking out individuals from business events, pro events by influencers or what have you. We've also talked about the company's secretary's recommendation. So these are just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ways that you can actually get bright people, intelligent people. It gives you the opportunity to assess them firsthand, or in the second place, you can assess them through referrals or through any of these mediums that we've actually mentioned. I'm not saying that this list is exclusive, no. All I'm saying is that these are some of the simplest ways through which you can get the brightest minds to work with the company in an advisory capacity or as independent directors, as the case may be. I hope that you would put some of these tips into practice and just let me know how well this has actually worked for you. And I'm sure that we can keep this conversation going on in the comment section.